The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 9th chapter, text number 26 and 27, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 16th, 1966, in New York.
Patram pushpam phalam tuyam, jumi bhaktapajichati, tadaham bhaktya upuhitam ashnami pravitātmana. Now, the Lord Krishna says that anyone who offers me in devotion these four things, patram pushpam phalam tuyam, a bit of leaf and a bit of flower, a little fruit and a little water. So he is pleased to take, except why? Because we are offering him with devotion and love. That is the only thing. Just like if you offer me varieties of foodstuff and very palatable dishes, but if I am not hungry, then all these palatable dishes and varieties of foods are useless. I cannot accept anything. Similarly, if you offer anything to the Supreme Lord, He is full. He does not require your offering. He is always being served by hundreds and thousands of goddesses of fortune. Lakshmi, Sahasra, Sata, Sambhama, Sebhamanam. We are in the material world, we are seeking the favor of goddess of fortune. But in the spiritual world, hundreds and thousands of the goddess of fortune, they are eagerly trying to serve the Supreme Lord. So, He is full. He has nothing to accept from you. But He likes that you should offer Him some. Just like a rich father, he does not like any help from the son. But if the son, after he is grown up, he is earning, and if you offer something to the father, he becomes very happy. This is natural. So, our connection with the Supreme Father is like that. He is not in want. He does not require anything from me, but it is for my interest. If I offer something, then I become a very great son of my father. This is called bhakti. This is devotional service of Krishna consciousness. And why should we not offer? Then we are ingratitude. Suppose the father is supplying everything, and if I do not offer anything to my father, is it very good business? No. So, yes, the ultimate, even the poorest of the poorest, he can offer these four things. Otherwise, if you have got means, you should prepare very nice foodstuff for the Lord. And in them, at Vrindavan, in India, there are temples still. They are spending thousands and thousands of rupees for palatable foodstuff offering to the deity. And those foodstuff are distributed to the, the devotees. No, not only devotees, even non-devotees. Come and take. Because by eating one shall be devote. Nobody shall eat. If I ask somebody, please come and hear Bhagavad Gita, he may not agree. But if I offer some palatable dishes, foodstuff, Krishna prasad, so everyone will accept. Everyone will accept. So that is one of the process of devotional service. That we should offer very sumptuously to the Lord, and the prasad should be distributed. The Lord is not taking away to his abode, to his kingdom. It is for you. But if you eat and if you distribute that sort of prasadam to the public, you are doing great service and the public is getting spiritual consciousness, God consciousness. Just establish, just propagate this everywhere, in the hospital, in the charitable societies, in industrial places, everywhere. Distribute this prasadam and chant this Hare Krishna. Just see what is the result. You want peace. These are the process of peace. But we do not take care of this, what is peace. Muktanam jagvatavasam sarvaloka mahasram, just we have discussed previously. This is simply acknowledged. There is a process of worship of the Ganges. You have perhaps heard the name of the Ganges River. The Ganges River is the sacred river. Ganges and the Jamuna, the most two sacred rivers in India. Millions of people take bath early in the morning in these two rivers. All parts of the country. It is very wide and very long river from Himalayan to the Bay of Bengal. So it is a very long river and all the tracts of land, they are considered the sacred place, and in each and every part thousands and thousands of people, they are taking their bath early in the morning, either in the winter season or in the summer season. It doesn't matter. So there is a process of worshipping the river Ganges. And what is that? After you take your bath, you stand up to your waist, fill up with water, and take little water from the Ganges water, and you offer Mother Ganges, I am offering this respect. This is the process. Now, suppose you take a handful of water from the Ganges. What is the loss of Ganges water? And if you offer some handful of water in the Ganges, what is the gain? So, this patram pusmam phalam tuyam, a bit of flower, a bit of fruit, and a bit of leaf, if you offer to the Supreme, do you mean to say he gained something? Or if you take it out of nature, you are taking so many things. Is he in loss? So he has no gain or loss. It is for your interest. When God accepts, he says, yes, I asnami, I eat. One Arya Samajist, you say, in the Hindu society, since very long time, especially since the days of India's disruption of the original culture, so many offshoots, they have come out under the name of so many evenings. So, there is one section who are called Arya Samajis. Their business is only to criticize all these pictures. That is their business. So, one of the members of the Arya Samajis, they do not favor the temple worship. So he asked me, Swamiji, do you think God eats? I said, yes. And how do you think? And because God says I eat. Here is, Krishna says, Asnami. So God says I eat. So who are you that he does not eat? I replied him like, who are you? You say that God does not eat. But here God says, I eat. So whom shall I believe? A loafer like you or Krishna? I am a third person, and you are also a third person, and Krishna is recognized, the Supreme Personality of God. Whom shall I believe? I accept that I am the fool number one. But whom shall I accept? You or Krishna? You say that you are. What are you? What is your position? You are an ordinary man. You say that God does not eat, but God says I eat. Now why shall I not believe? So this is the question of faith. This is the question of faith. And without faith, you cannot reach the kingdom of God. Your experimental knowledge, your so-called defective reasons and arguments and philosophy, that will not be applicable in the transcendental field. You have to believe. You are believing in every sphere of your life. When you purchase a ticket for transferring yourself in the aeroplane, if you go on arguing whether I am purchasing ticket, whether this aeroplane will reach, whether it will not crash in the way, if you go on arguing, there is no question of getting on the aeroplane. You have to believe that aeroplane will take me to the other side. You are doing that. There is no argument. So similarly, you have to believe. You must have faith. And we see that many faithful, great acharyas and devotees of the Lord, they achieve success by this faith. Why shall I not follow them? Therefore, the Vedic literature says that you have to follow the footprints of great acharyas. Acharya means great devotees who come to teach the people in general about God consciousness or Krishna consciousness. He is called acharya. He behaves in his life how to think of Krishna, and he teaches his students about that. He is called acharya. Achinati Shastrani. He knows the purport of the scriptures and he behaves in his life and he teaches his students in that way. He is called acharya. So we have to, in Bhagavad Gita, in the 13th chapter, you have read it, that acharya upasanam, you have to approach acharya. That is the way of learning transcendental knowledge. Then all Vedic teachers, tad vijnanartham sa gurumeva avigacchet. If you want to learn that transcendental science, then you have to approach the bona fide spiritual master. Tad vijnanartham, that means that transcendental, vijnan means science. If you want to learn, so the Vedic literature teaches us to accept the authorized, bona fide, spiritual master, acharya. The Krishna is the head of all acharyas. He is the principal acharya. From Krishna, Brahma learned this Vedic literature. From Brahma, Narada learned this Vedic literature. From Narada, Vyasadeva, Madhyacharya, from Madhyacharya, so many. In this way, the parampara system, the acharya system is coming down. So we have to believe that. Mahajana Veena Gatastra Pantha. You have to follow the footprints of acharya. Not only in the everywhere, the footprints of acharyas are followed. Just like in your country, you are following the footprints of Lord Jesus Christ. Yes, that is the way. Or any acharya. Because the acharya, they come here to teach us about Krishna consciousness or God consciousness. That is their business. They have no other business. That is bona fide acharya. If somebody claims that I am God, then he is fool number one. At once reject him. One who teaches about the message of God, he is acharya. So the Vedic literature teaches us that tattva pratishtha, in a spiritual matter, you cannot argue. Your argument will be failure, because he may be very good arguer, but I may come, I can cut all your arguments. And somebody else comes, he cuts all my arguments. It is a question of logic. So, there are many logical experts. So by arguments, we cannot reach the supreme truth. tatva pratishtha sutayo bhinya, not by purchasing books from the market and reading it. No, that also will not help you. Tatva pratishtha sutayo bhinya, if you purchase Bhagavad Gita, if you purchase Barber, you purchase Quran, there are so many, there are researchers, they are also authorized, that's all right. But you cannot learn them by your own study. One must go and learn it from the spiritual master. Exactly. You purchase from scientific book, medical science or engineering, and study at home. Oh, you'll not be never acknowledged as a medical practitioner. You have to admit yourself into the disciplic succession medical college. You have to attend lecture. Then, when you pass degree, then you will get it. So, sutayo vibhinna, nasumunidyasamatangna bhinnam, and if you consult different kinds of philosophers, you will be bewildered. But one philosopher is giving one opinion, another philosopher is giving, because nasumunidyasa, a philosopher is not philosopher if he does not cut another philosopher. That is going on. Nasumunidyasamatangna bhinnam, dharmasya tattam nitam guhayam. Therefore, the purpose of a spiritual life is very confidential. How I can learn? Mahajana jina gata sapantha. That we will accept the footprint of those recognized acharyas, acharya upasana. So Krishna is the best and foremost acharya, and he accepted the Supreme Personality of Godhead in India, all, schools of, transcendentalists, the impersonalists and the personalists, all of them, they have accepted Krishna as the Supreme Personality of God. There is no doubt about it. So here, his Lord says himself that I eat. So we cannot say that he does not eat. He does not eat in favor of my conclusion. There is no evidence. But here is the evidence, accepted evidence, that God eats. If God eats, then why don't you offer him to eat? What is the harm? What is the harm? Eat your little and fruits and flowers offered to God, he accepts it. Why don't you offer it? You want to please so many, you flatter so many bosses by supplying good dishes and so many things. Why don't you try to please God? What is the harm? Is there any loss? You are eating every day, and before eating, if you offer to God, what is the harm there? Why people do not take this formula? And see the result. If actually God eats from your hand, how much advanced you become in spiritual life, you do not know. He accepts your things from your hand. How much fortunate you are. So here is it. It is clearly said. Tadham asnami. Asnami, the Sanskrit word, means I eat. Why? Bhaktapuritam, he has brought with devotion and love. So you try to love God. You become a lover of God and offer him whatever you eat, whatever you do. Then see the result, how peaceful you become and how the world becomes peaceful. Simply by theoretical resolution, you can make peace in the world. Now resolve. We shall not fight. Next moment we are fighting. In UNESCO, resolution is going on for the last 20 years. And where is the peace? That is not the way of peace. Here is the peace. Try to establish your lost relationship with Krishna or God. And then there is peace. Now, Krishna says in the next verse, jat karosi, jadasnasi, jat juhosi, jadasi, jat. Jat tapasasi, kaunteya, tat purusha madarpanam. Now, every human being, he has got a philanthropic view. Now, the other day I met one gentleman, so I did not know that he is not a family man, because in India we are supposed to accept anyone, any gentleman as family man. So he said, yes, I am not family man. Then what he is doing, he is earning nicely, but he is helping one orphanage. That's nice. So he said that I have got many sons in this orphanage. And that's very good. So this natural inclination for loving an orphanage is there. Is there. So this give and take, this inclination is there in the human being. His Lord says that just karosi, and we have to work. It is not that without working we can have our body and soul maintained. This is not possible. This material world, we have to work. Everyone is working. Jatkarosi, jadasmasi, and we have to eat also. That is a fact. And jagjuhosi, and for our salvation or advancement, we do something, religious rituals, or attending church and temple or mosque, something there is in human society. And dadasidat, and charity. Everyone is more or less charitably disposed, and he makes some charity according to his capacity. Dadasidat, the tapasasi, and everyone accepts some penance, voluntary penance in his life. Yat tapasasi kaunteya tat purusha samadarpanam. Now, Lord Krishna says, all these activities, your work, your charity, your eating, your penance, and your rituals, everything should be done for me. That is Krishna consciousness. Everything should be done for you. If you want to work, well, work day and night, but you work for Krishna. That is Krishna consciousness. If you don't work, if you are simply eating, your father has got money and you are eating, eat for Krishna. What is that? You offer the same to Krishna and eat palatable dishes. Krishna will not take away your dishes. Simply offer it. Jadasmasi. Jadjuhosi. Oh, you are trying to elevate yourself to a higher standard of life. Just try to go back to Krishna, God, Godhead, and try for that. Accept all kinds of austerities and penances. Jadjuhosi. Dadasi. You are making some charity, all right. Make charity for Krishna. Well, Krishna is God, and he is very rich. Why should I make charity to Krishna? No, Krishna says, Dadasi, give me that charity. Give me that charity. Krishna is not poor, but you are very proud that you try to make charity with Krishna's property. I am thinking, I come here for a short duration of life. Say I am born in 100 years before or 50 years before, and I live here for 50 years and then go away. But I claim this is my property. Where from your property comes? Before your birth the property was there, and after your death the property will remain there. For thousands and millions of years. Where from you claim your property? You have no property. You are simply a outcomer, a guest. So you should accept that this is Krishna's property, this is God's property. You are falsely claiming that it is your property. It is not your property. So when Krishna asks you that give me in charity, so that you are foolishly thinking that it is your money. Krishna is just trying to take your money so that your false consciousness may be dispelled. Therefore, just like there is a nice story of Bali Maharaj. Bali Maharaj, he became a very strong king, and he nowadays, as in the modern age, you find a strong government or a strong king, he simply tries to conquer other countries. Formerly, they were able to conquer other planets also. They are so powerful. So this Bali Maharaj becomes so powerful that he conquered many of the higher planets of the demi gods. So it became a disturbing element. So God as incarnation, Bali Maharaj was also a grandson of a great devotee, Prahlad Maharaj. He had that blood of devotional blood. He had some devotion to Lord Krishna also. But at the same time, he was king. He was conquering life. He was king, making disturbance like that. So all the demigods prayed to Krishna to settle up this thing. So Krishna as Bhavan avatar, incarnation of Bhavan, a dwarf. Bhavan means dwarf. He went to Bali Maharaj and he was Brahmin. So as a Brahmin boy, so he asked some charity because the Kshatriyas, the kings are meant for giving charity. So he was very much pleased to see that beautiful dwarf boy. Yes, what do you want? I give you charity. But his spiritual master, so-called spiritual master, he could understand that this boy is Vishnu, God himself. He has come to cheat this Bali. So he asked his disciple, don't promise any charity to him because he is God. He'll take your everything. Once you agree to offer something, then he'll take yourself off. His God is very intelligent. Once you engage yourself in Krishna consciousness, there is no way out. You cannot go out. You cannot go out. He's so kind. As once you become sincerely a surrendered soul to Krishna, then there is no way out. You have to be Krishna. You have to continue to be Krishna consciousness. You cannot do otherwise. So this guru, the so-called guru, he thought, oh, if Krishna, the Brahman God, if he takes everything from my disciple, then how I shall live? I am living at his cost. And if he becomes a beggar, then I also become beggar. So he is very cautious. He said, oh, don't promise. Why? Hey, little boy, let me give you something. No, he is not this man. He is God. He is God. Oh, then you asked me not to give him. And he formally taught me that everything should be given to God. Now God is at my door. And you ask me not to give? Oh, I reject him. He had gone quite to a spiritual master like you. So any spiritual, so-called spiritual master is against God. He should be at once rejected, just like Bali Maharaj. So Bali Maharaj is one of the Mahajans whose footprints we have to follow. He has given tacit example. Anyone who is against God, he should be at once rejected. Never mind what he is. Yes. Never mind what he is. He should at once be rejected. This is the example of Bali Maharaj. So, Krishna also approached him as a beggar. So here he is also. He is alright. You are very, very powerful king. You have got much wealth. You think that yourself, that you are very much charitably disposed. Alright, give me some. So Krishna is so kind. So Dadashija, if you are in charity, give for charity. Charity for Krishna. Eating for Krishna. Working for Krishna. Sacrificing for Krishna. Everything for Krishna. Then you become perfect. Jatkarosi Dadasnasi Jat Juhosi Dadashija. Jat tapasasi kaunpiyo. Tapasya. Tapasya means penance. Oh. No, people are... There are great scientists, great philosophers, great thinkers, They are engaged in great penances. They are taking pains, very severe type of pains for discovering something. We have got the tendency, just like we have discovered this atomic bomb, that requires some penance or austerity. But Krishna says that don't discover atom bomb, but discover me. If you are so painstaking, if you are so great scientist, discover me. That is not possible. You can kill. That is possible. So this is going on. That tapasasi, kurusatam madhattam. Everything should be done for Krishna. That is the greatest civilization. That is the perfection of civilization. That is peaceful civilization. Everything for God. Thank you.